There was a man by the name of Charles Nalle, a fugitive slave from Virginia, and he was being held in the U.S. Commissioner's office. And all the abolitionists, oh well, they were pretty upset about the whole thing. So I just went about gathering information, and I made my plan. So I covered myself in an old shawl, and I walked up to the commissioner's office carrying a basket, a food basket. When I got there, the deputies thought I was the scrub woman for the building, and they let me in. So I went to the proceedings and I stood in the back of the room. When the decision was made to send Nalle back to Virginia, oh Lordy, that man went a little bit crazy. He broke loose and scrambled out onto the windowsill. But before he could jump off, the bailiffs caught him and dragged him back in. Then I went into action. I tore off my shawl and I seized one of the deputies, pulled him down, got another one, pulled him down, grabbed Nalle. And I cried out to my friends, drag me, drag us to the river. Now, this was not easy. Mm-mm. This was not easy. Time and time again, we were hit over the head with policemen's clubs. And when I got outside, another officer grabbed me. I took him by the throat, throttled him, and threw him over my shoulder. And folks were pulling at my clothes, took off my outer clothes, even pulled off my shoes. But I held on to the man, and I didn't let him go. And when I finally got him to the river, Nalle was still in chains, and blood was streaming from his face. And I tumbled him into the skiff that was waiting for him. And he took off. And then about 100 of abolitionists and myself, well, we got into a ferry boat and followed. We were gonna meet Nalle there at the end of the line. The telegraph beat us. They got there first. Because when Nalle landed, he was seized again and taken to the judge's office. So when we arrived in the ferry, excuse me one second, I don't know, this weather here is a little bit dry. But your water's sweet. Okay, where was I? Oh, at the judge's office. Well, when I landed, I gave a signal. And we rushed the judge's office. Now see, we were a mixed crowd of women and men. So we stormed up those stairs. And the first man to reach the door was this huge Negro man. And he pushed open the door. And a hatchet swung by one of the deputies fell him to the floor. And his body just blocked up the doorway. And then the deputies fired down, and two more were shot, and their bodies laid on the stairs. Now a number of colored women and myself, well, we just rushed over those bodies, pushed open those doors. I grabbed hold of Nalle again, and those women, they kept those deputies at bay until I carried Nalle out of there on my back and got him downstairs in the first wagon that came by. Well, I tumbled him over in that wagon. And that wagon driver, oh, he took off like a scald bobcat.